Hello everyone, this is Mirzai from Cal Poly Pomona, and in this lesson we are going to explore sensitivity analysis of a linear programming problem. In this series of videos related to the sensitivity analysis, we are in part 2 where we investigate 6 different changes in a linear programming problem parameters that can change the optimal solution. In this lesson, we are going to investigate change 5, which is adding a new variable or activity in a linear programming problem. To investigate adding a new variable or activity in a linear programming problem, suppose we have a linear programming problem and its optimal solution as shown on the screen. To understand this, the impact of adding a new variable or activity, you can think about this linear programming problem as a production plan for a manufacturing plant. Now, adding a new activity in this scenario is equal to adding a new product to the pool of product that you're already producing. Now, in this scenario, your production plan says that you have to produce X1 by 2 units and X3 by 8 units. However, let's say you are interested to know what your production plan is going to change by adding a new product. If you recall the system of equations that we have, it allows us to calculate the final optimal table given the basic variables in the optimal solution. Now, since in this scenario we already have the basic variables in the optimal solution, which are S1, X3, and X1, we can calculate the optimal table given these 3 basic variables. Because we are not currently producing the new activity or new product, so it will be considered as a non-basic variable in the final optimal table. With that definition, the only thing that is going to change by adding a new variable or activity is this part of your table. So basically you are going to have a new column and which represents the coefficient of that non-basic variable in the final table as well as the coefficient in the row of z. Let's look at one example to clarify this definition further in details. Suppose that a new activity added to the system and its resource consumption as well as its profit is given as follows. So your new product, if you start producing it, it's going to have $15 per unit of product as our profit, and the amount of resources that you need for 3 constraints that you are given is 1, 1, and 1. Now, to be able to understand whether the current production plan remains feasible or not, we have to calculate the coefficient of that non-basic variable in the row of z in the final table to figure out whether it's positive or negative. If it's positive or 0, it means that the current optimal solution is going to remain the same. However, because we are solving for maximization, so if we have negative in the row of z, it's a sign that we have to continue the table to the next table and find the optimal solution by doing iteration. So let's calculate the CBB inverse AJ minus CJ for this non-basic variable. With the notations that we already introduced in the part 1 of the sensitivity analysis lessons, you can form all those CBB inverse AJ minus CJ vectors and calculate the coefficient in the row of z. With this definition, the coefficient for the X4 or the 4th decision variable is going to be CBB inverse A4 minus C4. Our CB is not going to change because it's the coefficient of basic variables in the objective function. Our B inverse also is not going to change because we still have the same basic variable. And the only thing is for AJ and CJ, we have to put the A related to X4 and C related to X4 or the new variable. The new profit is $15, and if this is the amount of resources that we are using, you see that the value for CBB inverse AJ minus CJ is 5, which is a positive term. That's a sign that the current table is yet optimal and the production of the new product is not recommended. So basically, since our solution is not going to change, it means that we're going to keep X4 as a non-basic variable and its associated value is 0. Therefore, we're not going to have production of X4. However, there are scenarios that you get a negative value for C4, and then therefore you might end up producing C4 because you'll have to continue your table. Let's look at another example where we actually get a negative value for C4 and we have to continue our table. Let's see how we can approach that problem. Let's say this time your profit for C4 or new activity is 25 and your A4 is similar to the previous case. If I form my CBB inverse AJ minus CJ this time, the only thing is different with the previous example is that we have 25 instead of 15. Basically, I've increased the amount of profit for C4 to 25, and I want to see how that is going to change my decision. Now, with this increase in the profit of C4, am I going to produce C4, or it's more profitable to not produce X4. So in this scenario, you see that the amount of the value for C4 in the optimal table is going to be -5 in the row of Z. So let's show this in a simplex table. Basically, what I've calculated is that this coefficient here for X4 is -5. We can also fill this part, the coefficient of X4 in the final table. If you remember, that's equal to B inverse AJ. B inverse AJ is in fact a part of your CBB inverse A4. So we already have the B inverse A4 here. So this is the multiplication of these two matrices. So we can calculate that and fill those numbers in as well. So now this is your optimal table, given that you had X4 at the beginning in your problem statement. As you see, this table is not optimal anymore because you have a negative value in the row of Z. That's a sign that you have to continue the simplex table. In this scenario, when you have a negative value in the row of Z, your optimal table is not optimal anymore, because for maximization you have optimal when everything is positive or zero. We have a -5, so we have to continue this table to the next table. So we pick the most negative value here, and the only row that we can do the minimum test is the third row, so this becomes the pivot row, and we have to iterate and go to the next table. Using elementary row operation, you have to make sure that the pivot value has a value of 1 in the next iteration, which since it already has a value of 1, we keep it as it is. But for other values in this in the pivot column, I have to make sure we get 0 in the next table. If I implement the elementary row operation, for the second row, I have to multiply the pivot row in the new table by 2 and add it with the second row in the old table. And this is the new row that you get. If I implement the elementary row operation by multiplying the pivot row here by 5 and adding it with this row here, I get 0 for this element here. And if I implement this elementary row operation, this is the new first row that you get. And also, if I multiply the pivot row by 5 and adding it with this row, I'm able to generate 0 under X4 in the new table. And this is a new table that you get. Now in this new table, everything is positive in the row of Z, so that's a sign for optimality, so we don't need to continue. And the value for your objective function is 290. So you notice that the value of objective function from 280 in the previous table has come to 290 in the next table. And also your production plan has changed. Instead of producing X1, now you're producing X4. So the conclusion that you get from this solution is that if adding a new variable has enough profit that justifies its production, then usually we get a negative value for the row of Z, and then we have to iterate to find a new optimal table. We usually improve our objective function. But sometimes, as you saw in the previous example, we don't necessarily need to continue the table. With this, our lesson in sensitivity analysis of a linear programming problem, change 5, adding a new product or adding a new variable or activity, has concluded. Please refer to your Blackboard for your assignments.